Hello cubers, this puzzle here is called the Megamorphix. It was first created in the year 2004 by a guy called Adam Zamora. After that many others have created different variations of this puzzle, with the most popular one being the preload megamorphix, which is something like that, and the reload megamorphix, which where the shape is slightly different. I have also made one of these puzzles, the one I'm holding, for my personal collection. I find it an astonishing puzzle with very interesting and fun solving. I really can't take my hands off of it. It is really fun to solve this puzzle. This puzzle is a shape transformation of a 4x4 cube like this one here, where it has been chopped down and extended in such a way to create this shape, which is a tetrahedron. It is really not clear how a cube can be transformed into a shape like that, so I have created this puzzle here in order for you to better understand how this puzzle works and solves. As you can see, this one here is only a sticker variation of the 4x4 cube. As you can see here, this is the green face. Let's align it like that. This is the green face with the orange next to it and the white on the other side and the yellow on the bottom. So as you can see, if we compare the two puzzles side by side, this piece here, which is a corner piece. These two pieces here, which are edges. This piece here in the middle, the small one, which in this puzzle appears to be center of that face, is actually a corner piece, this one here. And if we turn it a bit like that, you can see that these four pieces here are actually these four center pieces. So although in this puzzle it looks like to be edges, they are in fact center pieces. Because of the stickering, as you can see the way the stickers go, the center pieces here have orientation, meaning that the orange side of the pieces has to be rotated on the upper side of the puzzle and the green to the below, to the bottom. This orientation causes this puzzle to act a bit like a super cube. And it's not entirely a super cube like this one, a 4x4 super cube, because there are similarities in the pieces. For example, this green piece here is similar to this green piece here and to this piece here, and they can change places without affecting the solved state of the puzzle. The same is here, this green piece 1, 2, and 3. But in this super cube, this piece here is completely different than this and this. So it acts a bit like a super cube, but not entirely. This fact causes some, how can I say it, pseudo parities to appear when solving it, which are very interesting and fun situations. Another very common misleading of this puzzle is that this corner piece here, which is this one, can be turned in all three different orientations without affecting the solid state, which of course can cause some other let's say problems, but I find them very fun to deal with them. If you don't own a megamorphics like this one, and I strongly suggest that you find a way to either make one or buy one. It is very interesting and extremely fun puzzle to solve, but nevertheless, if you wanted to experience the solving of this puzzle, go ahead and stick a 4x4 cube like this, like that, and I can assure you, you will enjoy it in every way. Solving wise, these two puzzles are the same. If you can solve this one, you can certainly solve this one as well. Now, there is a small, very small difference between the two puzzles when you solve them, but because it doesn't affect the solving of it very much, I will leave it to you to spot it. So if you have done so, please write it in the description. Which is the small difference between this puzzle and this puzzle while solving it? I hope you like it. Bye.